Hey guys, it's Vignesh from Code Android. In this video, we'll see about list view. List view is useful to arrange bunch of widgets into a scrollable list. To demonstrate this, I already created an empty Flutter project. In this, we have center as the body for the scaffold. Inside center, adding a list view. This list view requires multiple child, so we are getting children attribute instead of child. For the most part, we will have same UI for our list item. So, creating a function called list item, which will return our widget. For the list item, getting message as argument so that we can pass different values for our item. Inside the function, returning a card, inside adding the text as message. Finally, in our list view children, calling the list item function with different messages. You can see we got our list, but the items are too congested. So, I want to give 200 as height for each of the item. To do that, wrapping our text widget using center and then wrapping the center widget using sized box. Also, setting the sized box height as 200. You can see we got our list and I'm able to scroll to see all the items. But in most of the situations, we won't pass items like this. Instead, we will have a list of object. Using that list object, we will populate the list item. To do that, creating a class called list item and adding two properties, namely title and message. Also, adding the constructor so that we can create this object in single line. For the list, creating a variable called items, which is a type of list of list item. As we know, in stateful widget, init state will be executed only once. So, inside this function, adding some list item object inside our list. Now, we need to create the item from this list inside our list view. Using a for loop, looping the item, from that creating list item widget by passing the title. Here I'm restarting the application because we are adding the items into the list inside init state. So whenever we do any change on init state, then we need to go back to the previous screen and come or restart the application. In our case, we don't have previous page. So, restarting the application. You can see we got the list with 7 items. After seeing this code, we might get one question. If we are passing widgets as an array, then why can't we use column with single child scroll view? You can see there is no difference in the functionality. As per Flutter documentation, list view is optimized for handling similar children's. In our case, we have all the children's having same widget tree. In this case, list view will perform better than column with single child scroll view. But in both cases, all the widgets are created initially. This will affect if we have more number of items in the list as well as the list is changing at runtime. To solve this, we need to use listview.builder. In this case, only visible items are kept in memory and remaining items are created at runtime. So, most of the cases we might use listview.builder. For this, we need to pass a function as itemBuilder in which it should return the item widget. For this function, we get context as well as itemIndex as parameter. Using this, we need to build our list item at runtime. When we save this code, we are getting error on 7th item. Because The item builder is executed with item index as 8, but our list is having only 7 items. To limit that, we need to pass item count as list length. You can see now the error is gone. I want to display the message also in the list item, so wrapping the text using column and duplicating the text widget. Finally, adding title in the parameter and using the title for our first widget. Also, making the title as bold using text style. Finally, in our item builder, passing title and message to list item function. You can see we got both title and message in our list item, but I want it in the center. As we used column inside center, column will try to take as much height as possible. So setting its main axis size as main axis dot min so that it will take its children's height. You can see we got our title and message at the center of the list item. If we want our list item in reverse, then we will try to reverse the item in the list. But we have an attribute called reverse which does the exact same. You can see now we are getting the items in reverse order. Till now we have implemented vertical list view. What if we want our list view to scroll horizontally? For that, we have an attribute called scroll direction. Here, we need to pass an axis to it. When we pass the axis as horizontal, then the list item will be kept one after another and it will scroll horizontally. When we use horizontal list view, we will limit the height of the list view. To do that, wrapping the list view using sized box and setting the height as 200. Also, I want to set width limit for the list item so that we will not have different width for each of the item. So, setting width as 250 for the list item. You can see we got our horizontal list view. To change the scroll animation of the list view, we have an attribute called physics. If we want to disable the scroll, then we can pass never scrollable scroll physics as its value. You can see when we pass this, we are not able to scroll our list view. In these kind of scenarios, we can use scroll controller to scroll the list view on click of the button. Like this, we can create scrollable list in our Flutter project. That's all for this video, guys. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.